Hello from me, Lazar Christoph. Welcome to the special lesson of the Lazarus IDE course. And I'm doing this extra tutorial, because a new major version of the Lazarus IDE has just been released, which can of course be found on their website. Version 4.0 Major Version. We open this link and it opens here the Lazarus IDE page. Now here it shows us our operating system that we are currently on. If we want to download files for another, we click the triangle here and other versions open, for Windows 32, Windows 64, for different types of Linux, there is also one for Mac. So, since I'm and you see we automatically enter the site, here this arrow opens and the download process should start. I'll put the file on the desktop and press save. And the file will start downloading, which will take a few minutes. During that time, we'll take a look at what's new. You can see that here, where the new features are. The first one is about something else, and this news is about the new version, released on May 5th. We enter this page. It leads us to this topic. And here we have to click, to open the next page, where you can see what changes have been made in this version. The more interesting ones, in my opinion, are here in the components. There are some, in the development environment. We see that there are quite interesting things. Here you can see all this in detail. I will not dwell on this now, because the installation file has been downloaded. I go to the desktop and double-click on the Lazarus IDE icon. Here I choose execution, here I leave the default English. This is the initial window. I click next and now here we need to choose where to install Lazarus. If you're installing for the first time, by default it shows you your main drive in the directory. You can leave it like that. Now in my case, because I'm going to be doing a secondary installation, I'm going to check this box, and here I'm going to choose where this installation will be. In this case, I'm going to choose this disk. I select a new folder, which by default creates it with the name Lazarus. I click OK, and then click Next. Now here I need to choose a folder for the configuration files. I go there, create a new folder and it still names it by default, last_conf. I leave it and click Next. Now here, in this window, we can choose the type of installation, either full, either compact, or of our choice. I will not select anything at the moment. I leave the default full installation and click Next. Now here it asks me, should I delete the configuration files? I don't have either an active check mark for a shortcut on the desktop, and you should have it, check it. Then I click Next and install. We are waiting for it to install, which will take a few minutes. Once the installation is complete, you will see this window, where you click Finish. You will have an icon like this on your desktop. We click twice and you see here a completely new window opens, which wasn't there before, right? And these previous ones were there, we review them, it turns out that everything is fine. And here we have two options, to choose a look, classic or modern. And here for the source editor, we also need to choose, classic or modern. Okay, now we will choose a modern look to try it out. Actually, I decided to choose both modern ones, so we could see what they had in store for us. In my previous video, I showed the classic look because there was no choice. I'll link to it. And you see, here everything is ready for us in one window. Very interesting innovation for those who prefer. Everything to be compact. Although, I don't use this particular window, so I might remove it and actually make it like this. It should be a little wider, possibly, so I can make it like this. Interesting move, and I think it's quite convenient. And actually, interestingly, in the messages, I see a change here. Before, it was just one window, single. And here's the change in the source editor, it looks like Delphi. There's code, form. Interesting. That's something to look into. This version really has interesting changes in appearance. That's all for this tutorial. Best regards.